Say 45. Scooby dooby doo. I was supposed to go to therapy again today. This has been the third time trying this week. I've yet to see a fucking therapist.
Why?
Thank God I'm not suicidal or some shit. They keep fucking up on their end. Oh, he's sick. They just like, he's been sick the past, like, we tried to call you. What, did you get in touch with anybody? No. Like, I showed up at the fucking place again. I showed up at the office like, oh, he's not here. I'm like, eh, that'd be something cool to know if before I drove all the way over here. Oh, he tried to call you. Well, did you get me? Did you leave a message? That's two no's. What the fuck are you doing? So when I got some soul food, I was like, fuck it, I'm out. It's tough because, like, I got some meatloaf, some tilapia, greens, black-eyed peas, cabbage, corn.
Oh, shoot. Can you hold What's it down that? For a second? Xzibit's yeah. here. I gotta go. I gotta leave the studio.
Is that cool? That's fine, John. Okay. It's not like I fucking talk to you someone on here anywhere.
What? I can't Can leave you hold the it board. Down? I can't leave
Xzibit,
the board.
Xzibit needs me.
I can
Xzibit's
worry.
Coming in.
All right. I'll be right back.
Yeah, Xzibit's coming in. So anyway, yeah, shout out to Pryor's Fine Food. Over on the east side. If you happen to be there, if you're in Michigan, if you're in Detroit, you want some good old show food, go in there, tell them Judy sent you. They won't give you a discount or anything. But you can still say that. I'm on some real white girl shit today. I'm vaping. Pumpkin spice vape. And I gotta tell you, it's fucking delicious. It's like fucking smoking the cinnamon toast crunch. John says I can't hit the hookah on the air, so I was like, I'm doing meth or some shit. And I'm like, whatever, fine. Fine. No biggie. I don't give a fuck. John, are you there? Where's John? Oh, I forgot he left to get an Xzibit. We got Xzibit sitting in with us just to talk some shit. Let me set up my Zoom. So Xzibit's not alone. He was listening in with Who Kid. We're like, come on by, bro. And sure enough, he fucking did. He's on his job. He is on his motherfucking job. All right, let's see. Street life. They won't never let me sign it. Dog, I swear to God. Sorry, something went wrong. There, try again. Next. And it just keeps doing the same thing. Fuck you, Google. I'm trying to zoom with Xzibit, and this is the fucking shit I get. All right, we got Xzibit. I'm gonna rush through this show so I can fucking chow on goddamn on my meatloaf and shit. Meatloaf and gravy. It's still kind of chilly out today, or chilly out up here in Michigan, so it's like I need some comfort food. I'd be lying if I told you I didn't murk half the goddamn fish. I guess I went over there and ate my feelings. Like a fat chick. Just eating my feelings. It's like, oh, I can't get into see a therapist. I'm gonna go get some soul food. Fuck you. Hey, Kanan, can you send me the Zoom link to the, what's this fucking, J. Anthony Angelini at Gmail? Is anyone out there? All right. You get to see the behind the scenes shit in front of you. The transparency of this show is astounding. All right. Let's go. It is All Out Show. Oh, I gotta keep talking, or else John, fuck it. John's not even back yet. We can't go to music because John left his station. We talked about Kanye yesterday, and fucking sure enough, him fucking shitting on Pete Davidson, all it did was just blow up Pete Davidson some more. We told you. Now, that's negative for you, Kanye, because you don't want him to be known. You want him to disappear. You're smart. You just not set his fucking name and just let him disappear. Now he's going to be everywhere.
I made it back.
Did you? I was like, hey, let's go to a song. And I was like, oh, fuck, John's not even there to go to a song.
His car is so tall, he couldn't pull into the garage. It's like 7 feet tall. What the hell is he driving?
I don't know. I'll ask him. I'll ask Xzibit. He can drive whatever he wants. He pimps rides. Think of all the joy he's brought to people by pimping their rides. And like, if he wants to have a giant fucking car, truck. This is a truck or car?
He called it a tank.
Can you send me a Zoom link to JAnthonyAngelini@gmail.com? I can't. For some reason, I can't get on fucking. I can't get on my goddamn. My main Gmail on this computer.
Okay. By the way, you are aware you just said that on the air, right?
I don't give a fuck. I don't even check this goddamn shit.
Okay. My Gmail is just a spam folder at this point.
Yeah, that's all it is, man. And I wrote somebody back a year late because I didn't even realize how far behind I was. Like, I was in some weird folder. Vice had hit me up about doing some shit, and I was like, I hit him up a year late. I was like, dude,
I'm in.
I just realized that this is a year ago. My bad. I don't check this folder. All right. What's up, man? Let's play some music. We got Xzibit coming up next. It's an All Out Show. Let's go. Yo, yo.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
We got old friend of the show, X to the Z, Xzibit up in this bitch.
Yeah. What's good, Jude?
Fucking, I just knocked out some fucking soul food in between breaks. And okay. Now I'm sitting here talking to you.
All right. Yeah, man. I listen to the show. You know, I live in LA, so I'm driving around listening to you. And I think the tipping point was the pH balances when you were talking about the with Who Kid.
Oh, yeah.
The vagina smells. I was like, I gotta go drop in on my guys and make sure they're good.
That's Who Kid, man. Who could take stinky pussy and turn that into an hour long talk segment? I was like, all right, fine, I'm gonna roll with you, Who Kid. This is where we're gonna go.
Yeah, this is where we're going there. So I was like, yo, let me come up here and see what's up, man. What's good with you?
Shit. Speaking of stinky pussies, yeah. You're single now. Have you ran across any stinking ass pussies?
Yeah, man.
Make you wish you was married? Like, man, maybe we can work it out. We call her ass up.
Nah, man, I'm at an age now where that is not appealing to me whatsoever. I am with someone. You know what I'm
good
saying?
For you, yeah.
So I'm good. It was quite an experience. But yes, divorce is a motherfucker, man. You don't get to know somebody until you divorce them. That's my opinion.
It's like the true colors come out. I never even thought about that shit.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I was like, how did you keep that up for so long? You know what I'm saying? It's like...
It sounds like you had a vindictive one.
Ah, dude, it's... Well, I'm not gonna... Well, paper's not signed yet, so I'm not gonna I'm not gonna dive off that
God bless
that
you,
ledge.
Bro. Yeah, no. I don't want you to, man. Like, I'm not one of those guys that are like, hey, I need a good sound bite. Let's sacrifice this guy's everything so I got 30 seconds I can brag on.
Yeah.
Like, nah, dog. I just say no more, bro. Like, fuck, man.
Nah, I wouldn't say it's just been crazy because, you know, the whole COVID thing. And then, you know, on top of the personal side of things, you know what I'm saying? It's like everything hit at once. And, you know, being an entertainer, I know some people thrive off like having their drama and their shit like put into the motherfucking public, but I'm a very private person until I don't want to be.
Right.
And then, you know, like, that was like, it was weird because, you know, she was trying to put all my shit out in the street and, you know, nobody gave a fuck. Niggas was like, yo, I didn't even know you were married, so.
That's not, yeah, I didn't know either, bro. I was like, oh, he's getting a divorce? Like, this motherfucker's been married this whole goddamn time? Damn, like a ninja.
No, it was short, man. It was like 6 years, but I mean, it was still. You know what I'm saying?
Still,
it's
a
like,
little minute. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah. It was still, but I won't do it again. I tell you that. You know what I'm saying,
bro? I'm right there. I like, we can have a wedding. We can do all that shit. I ain't signing a fucking thing, bro. Like, I'm not signing. We can have a wedding, a cake. I'll dance. You can have your dad walk you down if you know that motherfucker. Like, I don't give a fuck. Like, yeah, let's do it. But I ain't signing a fucking thing.
Yeah,
bro.
I mean, but if you think about it, It's a business agreement. It's a
yeah.
Yeah, it's literally starting a corporation. You know, the same language and the same kind of rules and apply. Like yo, like this is a pretty deep shit, man.
Except for in business relationships, it's not like whoever's got more money gets to pay for that other motherfucker in perpetuity for the rest of their fucking. As long as that motherfucker is catching a breath and not married again, you get to pay for him. You're like, what the fuck?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, there's some bells and whistles that come along with it, but all in all, it's been good. You know what I'm saying? It's like, if I'm not complete, then I can't make nobody complete. But I am good. I'm with a, you know, wonderful woman. You know what I'm saying? I feel really good about the direction of life, and, you know, shit moves on. The show goes on.
That's such a positive outlet. Like, because you can either feel like mad and fucking like you've been a victim of the system, or like, you knew what you was getting into.
Yeah,
you're
for
fucking
sure.
Not dumb.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. I know what I'm doing. I know what I can do. You know what I'm saying. I know how I've been in tough situations before, and this is not that.
You're arguably one of the, like, so many rappers come and go and just aren't able to stick around, and you've been able to really carve out a spot for yourself.
In the
American culture, not just hip hop culture, but American culture. Whose idea was Pimp My Ride? Was it your idea, or did they come to you like, yo, we think you'd be good?
No, it wasn't my idea. It was a gentleman named Rick Herbitz. He came to me and asked me to do it because I was at West Coast Customs. I used to get my cars done there.
Oh.
So I just so happened to be there, and I was cracking jokes and shit in the fucking, you know, in the little garage, and Rick was there, you know, trying to, like, see if they want to do it and asked me if I want to host it. And I was like, nah, you know, because at the time, nothing was fucking, you know, people in hip-hop weren't doing shows like that.
No.
You know what I'm saying? It just was, it was frowned upon. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I was like, nah, you know, but then I thought, I was like, oh shit, well, if it's for MTV, then maybe they'll play my videos. You know what I'm saying? Like, maybe it'll be an upside for me in this shit. So that's when I fucking like decided to do it. We did like 13 episodes, and then, you know, that shit was on at like 10 o'clock at night, and then it just took off from there.
It's kind of great. Like, everybody wants to have their, I drive a Volt and I wouldn't mind that shit being fucking better, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, but you know, but back to your question, it's like when people ask me, you know, like when you ask me, how did you stay, or how did you, you know, take this and transition into that? Well, it's because I never was gonna be pigeonholed into somebody else's definition of who I needed to be. Right.
Yeah.
So I went through the music, you know, I love music. I still do music. I got a new album coming out. But, you know, that wasn't the ending point for me. I feel like at the end of the day, I'm a businessman. I like to build businesses. I like to do things from the ground up. I like to create, you know, something from nothing. And so that's where all of the Pimp My Ride ideas came from. I was like, yeah, I'll try it. You know, that's where the film and being the actor came in.
Yeah.
And then it just transformed into now I know how to build businesses. I didn't go to school. I didn't go to college. You know what I'm saying? I didn't do any of the marketing schools or any of those things. But being an artist taught me how to do all of these things. It taught me how to fucking market myself and put together projects and do budgets. You know, I still can't make a spreadsheet, but I can, you know, build the fuck out of a business. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I know the right people to put in place. So, you know, that's how I was able to stay. That's how I was able to create my lane and just stay in it, you know?
Another thing, too, is you literally, unbeknownst to you, you were doing an audition at a fucking... At a car place, so you genuinely give a fuck about cars. Like, yeah. it's not like, hey, let's put Xzibit in the circus or the fucking a baking show. Like, you don't give a fuck about baking. You give a fuck about cars. You know?
Yeah.
So it's not like you were selling out or anything like that. You were talking about shit that you liked.
Yeah, no, but it was just different at the time. You know what I'm saying?
I know. Yeah. Like, yo, I fucking... Hip-hop was so rigid with the rules and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
And then broke them all at the same time. You know what I mean? Like, oh, you can't... Like,
yeah. You was selling out when you did commercials. Like, when you did TV shows, when you did anything that was outside of the what was perceived as the culture at the time. You didn't do reality shows. Now... It's balls to the wall. People want to, you know, do everything. They will do a fucking baking show right now if it was going to get them on some screen time. You know?
Sign me up. Where can I sell out at? I will fucking, I'll sell out like a motherfucker. Keeping that shit real has been costly. Like, fuck that shit. Speaking of keeping it real, you just tweeted like, I hate motherfuckers. I don't like people that lie about their age.
Yeah.
And there's a bunch of you fuckers. Who are you talking about?
Yeah, well, that goes back to our original conversation, the top of the conversation.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Which was the fucking, the marriage shit? Or?
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, she was lying about her age the whole fucking time? God damn.
No, not the whole time, but just...
But long enough?
Yeah, just now, just recently. And I'm not going to blow her out like that, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, that was, it was the, her and a, yeah, her.
I was like, who is this guy mad at? Because that's one of them tweets that didn't come out of nowhere. You know what I mean? Like, that was applicable to you. Yeah.
Absolutely. But there's a lot of people that do that shit. I just don't get it.
I do because I'm on dating sites, right?
Yeah. So really?
Like, I just moved back. I don't know, though. But everybody I know is fucking, like, got wife and kids now and shit. Like, I'm lonely as hell. Like, I'm like, let's rage. They're like, I would. But, you know, I got the kids. I got to take them to soccer.
I do not
like,
envy you, bro. I couldn't imagine dating a younger woman right now. Couldn't imagine it. I wouldn't even know how to fucking talk to her.
Bro, like, I want to have some kids too, so I gotta get like a 30-something year old. You know what I mean? Like,
you don't got kids?
I got kid that I didn't raise. You know what I mean? I love her, but I didn't raise her. You know what I mean? I got kid that I didn't raise.
Wait, what? How the fuck did you not raise her?
I was a teen parent I didn't have any support, bro. Like, they had it all and just kind of like, took the baby and took my daughter and relocated her ass.
Damn, okay.
And I just, honestly, I was such a shitty dad. Like, by the time that shit happened, I was like, all right, peace.
He was like, cool.
All right, bet. I don't have to feel like such a piece of shit. She, like, I can't go see her all the time, you know. Fucking being a Debbie dad's motherfucker. So I'm trying to get a fucking, you know, mend those fences and then
you're gonna go get a do-over.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's crazy having a kid and you're like, who told you to eat that shit? You know what I mean? Like, why are you thinking like that? Like, what the fuck? Like, it's fucking crazy. You know, it's crazy. And it's like, that's them, but like, not, you got, it sounds like you got to participate in your kid's life.
Yeah, yeah. I'm getting a snip though. I'm cool. I'm going to get the snip. I'm done with kids. Fuck that.
No, how many kids you got? Like two, three?
Two.
Yeah. That's enough, bro.
Yeah.
And then you're going to just get to just bust loads and all types of just.
What the fuck?
You cum dumpster.
Classy.
Take that. Go ahead, John. Hit him with that. Once he get it, he's gonna be out there like. I can't wait till
a girl
tries.
Wait, that's a real song? Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I be nothing in these bitches.
Yeah, yeah.
I ain't gonna pull out. Oh, wow.
I don't even, classic. Yeah. We don't have the full song, but yeah. He came on Hate It or Love It and everything. Good guy, but like he's like, hey, it's been 4 years. It's a 4 year anniversary of nutting these bitches. Can I get back on? I was like, no, bro, no, you cannot. We'll keep playing the I be nutting these bitches, but you can't get can't get on.
That's
I wanted to ask you about the Super Bowl. Was it bittersweet to watch that shit? Because you were such a part of the chronic 2000, and it was just like, and you're in Los Angeles. I was looking for you, and I was just that's fucking crazy. What was it like watching that shit, you were such a big part?
Dude, I thought it was fucking amazing. You know, I felt like, you know, like, listen, you got the largest stage, arguably, in sports and entertainment in the whole world looking at you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Dr. Dre deserves that shine. Now, he's built universes as far as I'm concerned. You know, he's given me opportunities to be on tour with him, be on records with him, produce my records. And then I'm also spend a lot of time with Dre, like now, you know what I'm saying? Like working on music that he's creating, working, you know, just speaking to him as a friend. And so when you hear the logistics of what it took to make that show happen and the people that were involved, you know, they only had 12 minutes to perform. You got to fit Mary J. Blige, Eminem, Kendrick Lamar, Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, all into 50 Cent into 12 minutes. So, you know, like, dude, these guys are megastars. You know what I'm saying? I never felt slighted or like I wasn't involved, because when I see my brothers win, I feel like I win. So that's how I saw it. It's like, yo, these are my people up there rocking, and they're doing something that's never been done before. Fuck yeah, that's fucking amazing. You can't see it no other way.
That's an awesome attitude to take. I'm glad that is that a key to your success? Like kind of falling on the positive side.
What,
of things?
Not being a dickhead? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not being an emotional in your feelings ass. Motherfucker. Yeah.
Yeah. Not being a fucktard. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's part of the success.
Straight up.
Yeah.
I felt the same way. I was like, damn, this is fucking crazy,
dude. I was screaming. I was fucking. I was like 7 shots in. You know what I'm saying? I was like, fuck yeah, this fuck. Come on, dude. I was up there fucking like going off. Yeah. But yo, 50 Cent did do in the club, and he said my name. So technically, I was in the show.
There. Yeah. You were there. 50 is hot. Want them to love me like they look hot. Doug, I remember going to the bar like out in Cali, and they would run that. They'd run in the club back like 3 times in a row. Like
absolutely.
When that shit first dropped, oh, did you hear he got shot in the face? You're like, oh, yeah. I had the orthodontist motherfuckers telling me about him getting shot in the face. Like, that's good marketing, dog.
Good marketing?
Yeah.
Hell no. Fuck. I wouldn't want to do that. No thanks.
I mean, you got shot in the face early on. You might as well get paid for it later. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Got shot in the face. He's still smiling. Look at that. It's fucking crazy.
Turn the negative into a positive. Well, I got hit with a bottle, so I got a big-ass scar on the left side of my shit. Yeah.
That was some gang. Was it like some gang motherfuckers or what was it?
Nah, it was
that?
One dude. It was one dude, and it was like at a fucking bar. It was like the nigga was like you know those annoying guys. The hey man, what's up, man? You know, you look like a baller. You look familiar, man. You know, hey. And I was like, dude, I'm just trying to get some food. Thank you. And then, you know, it just progressed to be like, I was like, dude, just get the fuck away from me. And then he was like, this is my neighborhood. He immediately started gangbanging. Like, nigga, it's my neighborhood. I talk to anybody I fucking want to talk to. And then he started walking out the building. And I was like, I know what this means. So I walked out right behind him. Because my shit's in the car. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to wait till you come out. I come out here and you just dump out.
Right.
So he must have had the bottle in his, like, jacket or his pants or whatever. But he, like, took 2 steps, turned around, and, like, threw the bottle like a baseball.
Damn.
And, yeah, it's a Jack Daniels bottle. It cut half my fucking jaw line all the way.
Oh.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was an interesting night. I was ready to eat too, man. Shit was fucked up.
That's That was the one. Yeah, that was a crazy. That was, I really had a really that old dick riding, like, it's a combination of dick riding and like being like a tough guy at the same time.
Yeah, exactly. It was one of those. Yeah, and usually, and generally, you know, I'm you know, people are pretty cool when they come up. You know what I'm saying? And I'm really cool. I'm really gracious for that. You know, I love when people, you know, approach me and tell me that they enjoy my art or my motherfucking talent or something I created. Then yeah, I fucking fuck with you. You want a picture? That's light work. That's nothing. But, you know, when people come up with condescending, it's like, I'm not a fucking idiot. Like, bro, like, you know, don't try to come up and be funny because, you know, shit can happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, let it lie, you know? If you got something cool to say, then cool, but say it and keep moving.
Yeah, dog. Like, this is so weird, man. Yeah. Hey, you look like a baller, man. Like, yeah, thank you. And that's what I, even if I thought of that, I probably would never say that to a fucking other man. Hey, bro, you look like you're really fucking... doing the most.
But niggas is moving on you now. This was, and this happened years and years and years ago. But still, I mean, it happens to this day. You know what I'm saying? Like, people will move on you. They come up and, you know, look like they gonna say something cool, and then they try to do something slick. And so, you know, we don't play them games.
I remember, like, and I've told this story before, but like, I came from Michigan to Cali, and it was just, I wasn't used to the Mexican shit talking shit. They're like, what's up, bro? I'm like at 7-Eleven trying to, like, I'm in like North Hollywood somewhere and like trying to get to some meeting. I stopped to get 5-hour energy drink. He's like, what's up, man? You good, man? And I was like, yeah, bro, you good? Yeah, man, you good? Like, I was like, yeah, I'm doing great. I'm how are you doing? You just told me you're good, but it's like we're in a circle here. So, yeah, man, I'm good, man. Yeah, that's great. Yeah. He's like smiling, like, is he gonna fucking try to fuck me or fight me, dude? I don't know what the fuck to do.
He's probably on the sick one,
bro. Yeah, I think so, man. I think so. And you know, he had the whole cholo outfit on. I was like, all right, man, let me just get the fuck out of here. I don't know this neighborhood.
Yeah.
Get fucked up. You think you're in a good neighborhood because there's palm trees and shit. And
yeah, no, but that's all over California. Everywhere. Yeah. Don't come out here for the weather. You know what I'm saying? They'll run up on you.
That was one of my first dates I took to, this was like in 2000. I took her to MacArthur Park.
Yeah. What the fuck you doing over there?
Because I was driving by there, and I'm like, oh, man, they got fucking paddle boats and palm trees. And, like, little did I know they're, like, just serving all the heroin out of that bitch. Yeah. Like, as we're walking, everyone's like.
Yeah, it's over here.
Like, no, bro, I'm good. Do-do-do. What part of Cali did you come up in? Because you bounced around. You were, like, Detroit, Albuquerque.
Yeah.
Finally landed in Cali.
Yeah. When I started moving around and getting my own spots, I was in Venice most of the time. Yeah, once I got to Venice, you know, I got settled. You know, my son, you know, and my first son was born. I was 19, 20 years old, and we were in Venice. That's where we started. And so, you know, once I got a little money, I started moving around and just ended up in a valley. And I was like, this is great. I got a home out here. You know, started from the ground up. So when I was in Venice, it was dope because, you know, it was like right there next to the beach. You know what I'm saying? All my peoples was there. You know, it was nice to come from, you know, live next to the water, see all that, kind of like break my fucking myself out into the scene. And, you know, it was a great platform.
It's fucking awesome. Yeah. You, speaking of platforms, this has nothing to do with platforms, but you got some new shit come. You working on some new shit, right?
Yeah. Hell yeah. I haven't put out a record since 2012.
So a decade.
Right, right.
But you've been working. You've been doing acting and shit.
Yeah, but a solo record. But I have put out like four other albums with Be Real and Dimrick. And we call ourselves the Serial Killers. So we got like four projects out. And fuck, dude, that's been good because I've always wanted to be in a group, and you know, we've been able to crush that shit.
What's the difference? Like, obviously, you don't have to carry as much weight, but like, what's it like working in a group as opposed to solo? And what do you prefer?
Well, solo albums are, you know, if you do them right, it's really a real well displayed and presented performance of ideas and thoughts, you know, organized to a place where, you know, that shit is not redundant. and you got it all out there. You know what I'm saying? But then when it comes to fucking a group, you know, you flying in and just smashing your portion. And then it inspires the next guy to come in and smash their shit. So it's been cool to be able to, you know, work in that setting. But I'm used to doing solo albums.
Like, you're an OG, but Be Real is like a triple OG. Like, yeah, what's that like being with Be Real, man? That motherfucker is like fucking quadruple OG, man.
But you smoking good?
Yeah. I've been wanting to go on this show, and I'm afraid to smoke weed with his ass, man. Like, I don't like that shit.
Nah, you just be afraid when he puts you in a hot box.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, like that hot box shit, man.
That shit'll kill you.
I'm shook. Like, I got a book out. I didn't even call him. I'm like, fuck that, man. There's no way I'm smoking weed to sell that shit, bro.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
You've been around like M, fucking Dre, fucking Be Real, you yourself. I'm sure cats soaked up game from you. Like, what shit have you soaked up from? You always had a good work ethic though, haven't you? Like, what do those guys have in common?
Well, I think the mindset is the most important thing, right? So when I say the mindset, it's like we all have talents in our own different way. We all have individual, you know, like goals and agendas when it comes to like being who we are. And so the thing that brings us all together, the thing that's similar throughout all of this is the mindset. The mindset of being, you know, coming into a position and not bringing your bullshit with you, but coming to the table and actually bringing something to the table, you know. There's some people that bring the table to the table, but you know what I'm saying? Like Dre is the table, you know what I'm saying? Right. Like, don't get it fucked up. Like, Dre is the table. And so when all of us come to it, we play by his rules. You know what I'm saying? We have manners. You know, some people can't get past their own bullshit to realize what the rules are and play by them. You know,
well, hip hop is such a like an egotistical fucking deal. To have to like be like, all right, this dude's the big dog. Like, understanding the hierarchy and be like, all right, okay, that's number one. That's number two. Let me get in where I fit in. You know, like I've even seen it on this side. Like, cats have a real hard time playing their position.
Right. Well, if you didn't need me, why the fuck are you here?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like that's the thing. And some people don't look at it like that. You know, for me, I feel like what I was accepted into do working with these juggernaut artists. You know what I'm saying? Like, A, it was about, okay, it's not about an ego stroke. It's about, can I be as consistent and can I create something that is on the level, on the par of what they're creating? Mm-hmm. You know, that was the goal, and that's the mission when I was brought into the fold. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like, oh, this nigga got this, so I need to get that. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of cats don't understand. Like it's not about a dollar amount because you don't know what they had to do to get that dollar. You know what I'm saying? So you got to be the best you. And then you got to come in and play well with others. You know what I'm saying? Some people come in and just fuck it all the way up. You know what I'm saying?
Can you say any names, or is that going to start?
I think it's obvious to people who have had great opportunities and fucking squandered it by being dickheads, you know?
It's that ego shit, bro. Like, it really, like, cats, as you were talking, like, I started reevaluating my shit. Like, I'm actually a number two. Like, I should be second man on the mic. I shouldn't be driving the car. Like, I
heard you say that the other day. I was listening to you, and you said, and they was like, how come you didn't go to this? Well, who kid was asking you, how come you didn't go somewhere or you weren't at some event? And he was like, nigga, I washed the dishes. You know what I'm saying? nah, bro. You are not. You are an essential part of this organization. But absolutely.
I think I'd still be a stronger number two than second man than number one. No. I'm going to say none of my wacky shit. I just got to be like, oh, and what's next on this thing?
You don't want to be you don't want to be the chin. You're saying you want to be the chin.
What's wrong with that?
Chin ain't number two. Chin's just a default number two. He's like a number just seven. Around. If we had a full show, he wouldn't even touch the mic.
I've got some high points. We got
some come on now.
I got some high points. Old Man River. You didn't even dress up for Xzibit, did you? You knew Xzibit was coming in. Probably wearing a fucking busted ass t-shirt with the fucking neck all stretched out from your big ass chin.
Wow.
Today I actually put on pants for Xzibit. I did.
Yeah, yeah. He does have a fishing hat on. It looks like a fishing hat.
It's like EPMD?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, there you go.
Oh no. Sandlot.
I
look like Sandlot with a big ass propeller fucking head.
I think this is an okay look for Xzibit, no? All right.
Bro, you look like if Moby had AIDS.
Why?
Straight up.
Somebody wants me.
I know they do. That's the crazy shit. There's somebody out there for everyone. There's
absolutely.
No,
after John, there's somebody out there for you,
she's,
man.
She's out there. I'll find her.
There you go.
Y'all didn't hear behind this, like when the music was off. Xzibit didn't know what John looked like, and he was like, "Wait, hold up, you're the chin?
That's the guy."
I was like, I've been talking to the chin the whole time. Yeah, yo, man, but man, he's very detail oriented. He called me and we'd been working on this for about a week and here we are, man. Good job, man.
Did you hear that?
Shout out to the chin. Yeah, I was like, can't hear it over your fucking chin, but yeah, I heard that shit. He's like, that's him dressing up, looking like he's waiting for a bone marrow transplant. That's John fucking dressing up. Jesus Christ.
Look at a hipster. What do you want?
You got 50 shades of green. You got like every type of, like, you got pea soup and like a half of gray.
You got the belt on.
You look like depression.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man.
Hell yeah.
Hey, yo, you're not wearing a big chains no more. I just peeped. Like last time you had one. Giant motherfucker. Yeah,
yeah, I got one. It's one of the it's the napalm chain. Yeah.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah.
All right. I got to ask you this shit. It's totally off topic, like you kind of came up or got put on by one of my favorite MCs, Tash.
Yes.
What's up with Tash? What's he been up to? And for y'all that don't know, it's part of the Alcoholics.
Yeah.
And like one of the fucking funniest, his rhymes always just are so fucking clever, dog.
Yeah. They just did an episode of Drink Champs.
Nice.
Yeah. And Tash is doing well, man. He's got completely sober. You know what
Damn.
I'm saying? Yeah. He talks about that, and that was a big deal for him. So I'm proud of him. I'm proud of my guy. You know, I've seen him lately, and he looks healthy. You know what I'm saying? It's the healthiest I've seen him in a while. And people are just rooting for him. You know, he's a really dope MC. He's a dope person. So it's good to see him, you know, moving forward.
That's cool, bro. Yeah. Shout out to Tash. Yeah. Shout out to you, Xzibit. When do you think? When do you see your next album dropping?
Well, I'm putting up, you know, like a few more rounds of music. I'm thinking it's going to be ready this year, but I don't know if I'm going to drop it. I don't know if I'm going to drop it into this year or top of next year. But I really want to time it because there's some bigger things in play that's happening now. So I'm kind of like waiting to drop. Alongside these events that are going to happen,
is that more like acting and
no,
it's all music related.
Yeah, okay. all music related.
All right, okay. Yeah. Let's go to the phone lines 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. We got Xzibit here. Holler at him. Who we got, John?
Got Wallace, who's a trucker. So it's on the road.
Wallace.
Yeah. What up? What's good?
What's good, man?
Ain't nothing but, hey man, your boy done answered probably 90% of the questions I asked you, 90% of the questions that I had for you. But it's cool.
All
you
right.
Said, man, it's all right, though.
Okay. I'm doing my job. 50, good.
Nah, you right. Do your thing, baby. I see you. You're doing it. Listen, I'm 55, right?
Yeah.
I've been in the rap game a long time, like even when it first started.
Mm-hmm.
But my thing is, yo, we miss you out here because I used to ask my man, like, yo, you heard anything about Xzibit? Like, where he at? And, I mean, I see you do a lot of shows or, you know, the car thing and things like that. So I know you've been working underneath the grid.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, we ain't seen you out there. And I'm like, yo, you was doing your thing back there. And to me, I think you could have reached that level, you understand me, of one of those greats. You are. Not saying you're not.
Yeah.
But, I mean,
just not enough work.
Yeah, just more. Work. Yeah, just more. Well, yeah, you know. Yeah,
right. So.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Well, let me jump in. Nobody asked you why yet. Like, why did it take? Why were you gone for 10 years?
Bro. Okay. So look. So everybody hears horror stories about the industry. Everybody hears horror stories about artists that don't, you know, get paid for their records and doing all that shit, right?
Yeah.
So I had a little bit of that feeling coming into like my later albums.
Yeah.
And once it was going that direction, it was like, I can do something else. Like, I'm not here to become a bitter ass artist. Like, if you guys don't want to fucking play ball, guess what? I'm multi hyphenate. I can go and fucking do something else. And then when you guys are got your head out of your ass, then I'll be back. You know what I'm saying? So that's why, you know, when shit starts getting funny, it's like, I'm not sticking around for fucking you to complete your mission. Yeah. So it wasn't like I didn't want to put records out. It was just like, I gotta feed my family, and if you guys want to play games, then look, I'll see you guys in a minute, and so I can go do something else. And I did, and I build this shit up, and now I come back and do music on my terms. I do it because I want to, not because I have to.
I used to hear those horror stories, and then once I lived mine, I was like, I understand why a motherfucker would, why, like, it's to pour your heart out on a record or some shit like that, and then watch some other motherfucker that hasn't done a fucking thing take your dough and tie up your rights and shit. You're like, what the fuck is this? It makes you not want to create.
Correct. And that's the wall, and that's the struggle, you know, because you don't want to become that guy who, you know, gets in front of everybody and vents and, you know, and like, fuck this, fuck that person, fuck this person, this nigga hold me back, this nigga do it. I don't do that shit. That shit is weak as fuck to me. It's like, listen, you sign the paperwork, you had the same 24 hours in a day as everybody else. You could have negotiated a better thing and a better that, and that's part of being a businessman. That's part of knowing exactly what you want out of things and knowing what to ask for and educating yourself about what's supposed to happen. Nobody's going to hold your hand through this process. So, you know, like, I've done really well for myself, you know, without much help. You know what I'm saying? So I've had to really learn some really important and expensive lessons, but I learned them. And so that's what makes me a better person coming back into what I love, because now, you know, I do music. I've had my studio cracking, and I've let other people come and work in it. I produce for other people. I produce these serial killer records. I've been doing music, but I'm not trying to like kill myself to be in the limelight. Like, we have a natural presence here. We have an organic presence here in hip hop, in culture. You know what I'm saying? And there's no reason for me to try to break my neck to be out here, you know, tap dancing in front of motherfuckers. Like, please like me. You know what I'm saying? That's the quickest way to wear out your welcome. So, you know, like, yeah, you know, like, when I come back and you can hear the confidence I have in the music, it's going to show. And it's going to be to my best benefit to wait until I feel like that.
You great answer. 888-742-3345. We got Xzibit sitting in.
Got Samir over in Philly.
All right, Samir.
Hey, what's going on?
What's good, sir? How are you?
How you doing, Xzibit, man? I got a question for you, big dog, and I was just wondering if you could help me to the best of your ability.
Copy that. What was the question?
So look, me and my brother, we some young black entrepreneurs. He grew up in Philadelphia. I grew up in Wilmington, Delaware. And we come from, you know, some toxic environments. And you know how that is. And just being around people your whole life and just trying to be young black successful entrepreneurs. Me and my brother moved to Puerto Rico last year. And we opened up a restaurant called Drip Kitchen. We the only soul food restaurant and barbecue in Puerto Rico. But the thing that we have in trouble with is it's just us out here. You know what I mean? So, like, besides it's just us having our back, we need a little help. You get what I'm saying? So,
what do you mean you need more money, or you need someone to fucking shout your shit out? Like, what do you need?
Well, really, it's funding is always, OPM is always a good thing. You know, we need that education, John, that knowledge to learn how to get. Right.
John, really, what, really, what, John? What, you fucking, the he, second caller, he's got, you got some guy asking for money?
What he said he wanted to talk about was how do you stay focused on your dream when you're involved in a toxic environment? That, and I said, keep it simple. And he promised
how do you stay focused on your dream when without.
It sounded like he was. It sounded like he was selling us some Puerto Rican barbecue.
Yeah, dog. Yeah, it is. I didn't hear that question at all.
He plugged his restaurant. Man, that's cool.
Yeah. As soon as he started taking us around the long way, I'm like, oh, bro, it's about to be. He's about to come in with an ask.
He's like, other bro, people's money up? Is always good.
What's up, my brother? Yeah, man, just hard out here, man, struggling. Like, if you don't fucking look out for me, you a sellout.
Yeah,
damn.
Yeah, he was about to hit us with that dollar, though.
Yeah, he couched that shit real fucking nice. I was like, oh, man, let's just cut to the chase. How much money you want? You know he's going to own a part of this shit. You know that, right?
Yeah.
How often, like, how do you handle that shit and handle it gracefully? I'm sure you're approached a lot.
Oh, yeah. You know, money changes everyone. That's just how it goes. It's just... It's weird. You know what I'm saying? Like, my first single, Paparazzi, was like, niggas in the rap game only for the money and the fame. Extra large.
Paparazzi.
And you know, I've always had like this thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm a creative. My satisfaction comes from having nice things. Yes, I like the fruits of my labor. But really, my enjoyment comes from the labor. My enjoyment comes from like having an idea, putting it on paper, making whatever widgets need to be made to make it, and then seeing it exist. And then when people appreciate it, that's the other part of the enjoyment. It's like, fuck, I made something that people fucking like, right? Mm. So I've never been driven by, oh, you know what I'm saying, oh, the money has to be there. You know what I'm saying? I've been offered big shit to do, you know what I'm saying, for money that I just didn't like agree with. And so then I've also done things that didn't have a big budget, but I agreed with it so much, or I believed in it so much, I was all in, right? So it goes back and forth. But, you know, I say that to say this. When I, you know, I became the first millionaire in my family, right? And so, you know, people come out the woodworks to get at you at the end of the day, for money. And it's the weirdest thing because it'd be people close to you. It'd be people that don't know you that just come out the woodworks and just don't understand what it takes to make the money that has been made. They don't understand the hours and the days and weeks and years it takes to actually get a paycheck from doing something like art. You know what I'm saying?
So, and art takes a lot of risk and a lot of sacrifice. You know
absolutely.
What I mean? It's not like, oh, let me just come on out here and I'm about to blow up. Like, no one saw you writing rhymes and all that shit sucks and going to fucking open mics and having a freestyle against motherfuckers.
Right.
No one sees that. They just see exhibits on television.
Right.
Can I get some money? And if you don't give me no money, you ain't shit.
I had to learn, you know, in the most recent years, it's okay to say no. You know what I'm saying? I've been saying no for a long time now. You know what I'm saying? Like I should have been saying no a long time ago. You know?
But it actually feels awesome to say no, doesn't
yeah,
it?
You're yeah,
like,
yeah.
Nah, bro.
Yeah,
no.
And I used to be worried about, you know, losing people or making people upset. I don't give a fuck right now. You know what I'm saying? And I'll look, if it don't make sense, if it's not for something that I believe in, then fuck out of here. You go do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not gonna, my finances and my resources are for, you know, things that I want to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's up to your discretion.
Yeah, yeah. And it's okay for me to say no to you. You know what I'm saying? And you got to walk with that or not. You know what I'm saying? Or you could just be like, fuck me and fuck off and do all that. I get that. But say that over there. Because when you say fuck me, my life doesn't change that much. But when I say fuck you, your shit changes. You know what I'm saying? So tread lightly, bro.
Yeah. That's the fucking truth. And it's like... No one owes you anything.
Absolutely.
If you're listening out there. Like, nobody owes you shit, dog. Yeah. Like, nobody owes you a fucking thing. You got to go get it. No one's going to hand you something. And if it's handed to you, be grateful.
Yeah, yeah.
But
well, I don't even get that. I get motherfuckers that be like, it's not enough. The people I do shit for, they like, it's not enough.
You fix them a plate and they want seconds, but it's cold. You're like, come on, man, which one is it? You want more anise? Food's awful and the servings are small. You're like, come on, man, like, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, then go somewhere else.
Yes, it's. I see athletes and rappers always they fall into that shit, man. It's tough. Yeah. Like, I don't know how many times we've had rappers come up to the show and it's just they got fucking seven dudes with them and it's like, don't y'all have a fucking job? It's the middle of the fucking day. Like,
that is their job. You like, know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and it's a real, like, talking about toxic. It's like a toxic relationship because
having somebody's back is not a job. Just if you're out there listening, having someone's back is not a fucking job. You being part of an entourage is not a job. You just waiting on shit to fall off the table. My nigga, bring something to the table. You know what I'm saying? And if you're not bringing nothing to the table, don't sit out.
I couldn't. You said that shit perfectly, and it's just like. we were talking about Kanye West going crazy on Pete Davidson, and it's like he's got no friends. Like, if I was Kanye's friend, I'd be like, whoa, 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 get that dude to put the fucking marker down. Like, quit drawing pictures of this fucking dude. Like, what's get him out of your rhyme, dog. Get him out of your fucking. You ain't even funny, man. Fucking.
Yeah, that's the whole thing. Did you see
that
documentary?
People are to the streets.
Did you see that documentary?
No, I haven't seen it, but I heard it's good.
It's good.
I heard it's fucking awesome.
It's good, man. It's good. They did a good job on that.
It is a good documentary. But like you see that shit over and over and over again. When you got everybody, the only people around you on your payroll, no one's gonna tell you the truth.
Yeah, real. My circle's small, man. My circle's small as a fucking dime. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I have the same people around me all the time, and I don't really venture outside of that. You know what I'm saying? I know, you know, I've learned my lesson. Like, you know what I'm saying? My shit don't get out in the street. My shit don't be everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas don't know my moves and broadcast them. Nothing gets leaked. Nothing gets fucked up. No lawsuits. No, none of that shit. Like, I keep my shit really, really tight. You know what I'm saying? That's a big part of it.
Is that like, when did you start doing that? As you got older, or were you always about that shit?
No, I've been blessed with some real markers in my life. Like, when people try to count you out, or people try to do talk shit, or feel like, you know, what you're going through is you're never going to come back from, they'll make it known how they feel about you. You know what I'm saying? I've been blessed to have, like, some real eye-opening situations with people who I never thought would turn on me or twist on me or do some weird shit to me. And then when I come back from it, of course these people try to fucking show back up. But I'm not with that. You know what I'm saying? It's like either you in or you out. You know, good, bad, or indifferent. Like, if you ride with me, then ride with me. You know what I'm saying? And so when it's good for me, it's good for everybody. When it's bad for me, we all pull together and we make some stone soup. You know what I'm saying? Like, we pull it together. But, you know, I've learned that, you know, just because people get behind you don't mean they got your back. You know what I'm saying? And just because, like I said, like, just hanging out with me does not help me. You just weigh more. Now you made the mountain weigh more. You know what I'm saying? So, you're not helping me. You just like living on the mountain, but you don't like carrying this motherfucker, which I have to do. Yeah. So I had to, like, separate church and state and be like, look, you know, you guys are my friends, then be friends. But, you know, I can't mix business with friendship and business with blood and all this other shit, because it just comes back to bite me in the ass every time.
Every fucking time. Well put. That's hearing a grown-up talk. Xzibit. I hope you come back when you're ready to when the album's ready to go.
Kingmaker, man, I'm fucking excited about it. I got I got this song called The Moment right now. That, bro, I just got the sample cleared, and I'm really excited. It's the A-Team. We flipped the A-Team sample.
Oh,
and,
nice, dog.
And it's me, Problem, and Busta Rhymes. And it's fucking phenomenal. I can't wait to do this shit live. I can't wait to do this shit live. Oh, it's God. Like it's like one of them records. It's like, wow, okay, cool. That nigga's tripping.
I swear to God, we were driving home from like Christmas dinner, talking about the A-Team needs to get sampled. Like I swear to you, bro, and you went and fucking did it. It was fucking awesome.
me and Focus produced it. When I told Focus we was gonna flip the A-Team, he was like, "Get the fuck out of here! We ain't doing that shit. That shit's a fucking that. No way. There's nothing hip hop about that fucking song."
Pull up the A-Team. Pull up the A-Team. This shit goes so dumb hard. What is he talking about? The 18 theme is fucking dumb hard. Like,
we crushed it though, man. I can't wait to play it.
I put it there with like as far as like when Cam did the Magnum PI shit. Like, like it's gonna, like when you said that, I was like, oh boy, that's gonna be fucking tough, though.
Bro, it is. When instead of coming together. You know, it just really was dope because I went to go sit with Mike Post. Mike Post was one of the original writers and creators of the A-Team theme music. He still does, you know, Law and Order, all the little boom. Doo-doom. Oh, yeah, he does all that. He programs that. He that's it.
Yeah, bring that shit up. Oh, that's hard, dude. Yeah. What are you talking about? And especially if you're a 70s or 80s baby, that's just gonna touch you, dude, like fucking right in your heart core.
Dude, but the way that it came together and Mike, you know, was gracious enough to, we sat in with him, went to a studio and played it for him, and he was fucking like really down with it. So to get his blessing and to know that we're gonna be able to present it the way we created it is really dope. We don't gotta change it. We don't gotta do shit. We just gotta put it out. It's fucking phenomenal.
Problem Buster, you. That's fucking awesome.
It's called The Moment. So when you see that come across your timeline, go ahead and put your ear to it. No bullshit. It's crazy.
Xzibit, I appreciate you coming by, man. You don't be a stranger, man. Come by and fucking talk some shit, dog.
Come on, man, every time.
Or some shit, bro.
Hell yeah.
You're more than welcome.
All right, cool.
All right, that's Xzibit. Where can they follow you and find all your shit and all that stuff?
Yo, follow me at Xzibit, X-Z-I-B-I-T, on all social media platforms. Brat.
Shout out to Xzibit. Peace. Let's go.
What's the difference between me and you? What's the difference between me and you?
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Make me feel good.
Oh yeah, it's Feel Good Friday on the All Out Show. Tell us what you feel good about. 888-SHADE-45.
It's Feel Good Friday. What are you feeling good for? What are you happy about? What are you grateful for? Call up right now and let us know. Let us know. What am I happy about? I got to have some good ass food. Shout out to Pryor's. Pryor Fine Food, I believe. I'm gonna fuck up the name. I had some fucking tilapia. I'm also grains, black eyed peas, cabbage. John said I can't hit the hookah on the air because it sounds like a meth house, but we're gonna have. It's not as bad on this than on the telephone, is it?
Weird. You got your bubbler going?
Yeah, I got my fucking hookah, bro. Got my little portable shisha. What else do I feel good for? I know it's going to sound crazy, but like, I'm going to wait for Instagram to punch me in the face for a really long time and take away my Instagram account. And they did. And it really didn't fucking matter. Sometimes the shit that you're like worried about, like when it actually happens, it's just not even that big of a deal, and you spend all this time like worrying about the shit. Sure, they decimated me, but like whatever, dog. Like I'm still Jude. You're not defined by how many fucking followers you have. And I'm also grateful to all y'all that have that bought the new book. It's actually doing pretty good, man. I'm happy with the sales and it getting out there, and thank you for all of the reviews and the positive feedback and just the support. And I hopefully it's it's a piece of art that y'all value as much as I value y'all supporting it. A lot of cats was buying it just to be nice and shit, but like, yo, it's really, it's a banger. It's a motherfucking banger. I do miss Chris, because I want to ask John what he feels good about, and he has to do it to himself. John, what are you feeling good for?
Oh, I've got plenty of things that I'm really happy.
He's got to do it to himself. Oh, fucking, where's Chris? What are you actually, are you looking forward to anything? I don't give a fuck.
Oh, this fucking lady finally got out of our house. Oh,
that psychopath, bitch.
I'm so happy about that. It's like a cloud has lifted. On her way out the door, though, she fucking filed these bogus restraining orders on some guys. I was like, oh, you fucking idiot. What a jackass.
Man, fucking, really?
Now how do you, she's like, gone. I mean,
can you even prove that shit? Like, I've never had a restraining order filed against me, nor have I filed one. So I don't even know how that shit works.
No, I mean, it seems like all she had to do was just, but she does this for a living. So this is like her thing. Like, oh, I don't like you. Here's a restraining order. I mean, it was like, it was written like a child. He was mean to me. I know. And she's like, she's this hot young lady. I don't know what the
doesn't
fuck.
Doesn't the judge, like, the judge is like, you're fucking 22 years old and you've got 15 restraining orders out.
What
maybe you're the problem.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, no one ever holds these motherfuckers accountable. Like, maybe you're the fucking problem, you fucking psychopath cuckoo bird.
Nutcase.
Oh, I bet you she had some good pussy. Some psycho pussy.
Oh, the Lamborghinis, they drive up in the middle of the night. So something was going on.
A lot of times they just look good in the picture, though.
Yeah, she was pretty hot.
Yeah.
But the crazy really negated any hotness she had going on.
What a waste.
Yeah, I was like, why?
Bless me. All right, we're going to play some music. Nah, Xzibit was just on. Shout out to Xzibit. Xzibit's one of those dudes. It's like, he'll come by the show every now and again, and then every time he comes by the show, I'm like, oh man, why don't we have more of Xzibit on? But he's off doing his shit, making money and stuff. He will be back when he's dropping the new album. This is an old single from back in the day. What you see is what you get. It's a dope video. If you never saw it before, you should go check it out on YouTube or some shit like that. It's all like one shot. Or it's shot like it's all one shot. Let's go. It is the All Out Show.
And so it was written. And after all these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shay 45, it's Feel Good Friday. What are you feeling good for? Call up right now. Let us know.
Got
888-742-3355.
Phil in Dallas.
Phil, what up, man?
What's up, Rude Jude? Man just did 2 years probation for a DWI. Mm.
And now you're fucking, you don't got to drop piss or nothing, huh?
Man, I can do whatever the fuck I want. I had a breathalyzer in my car for the whole 2 years. Everything. The shit was fucked up, man.
Yeah, I forgot that they did that to the drunk drivers. You got to blow before you can even fucking turn the key and shit.
Yeah, I hate if a nigga was trying to rob or kill me, because I'd be fucking with that machine. You got to wait for that bitch to start up, warm up, and all kind of shit, man.
I remember, there was some chick I was fucking with that had that shit, and I was trying to get rid of her ass, and I had to go downstairs and blow in the fucking thing for her just to get her to leave. I don't know if she was just making that up or what.
Yeah, but like 2 minutes, but maybe so. But like 2 minutes later, you got to blow in that motherfucker again. So
yeah,
it was fucked.
Yeah, I was gonna say she never said anything to me, but I was kind of wondering about that. I didn't care just as long as she left. I was like, sure, I'll blow in the fucking thing. But yeah, there you go. So she was full of shit. I just remember having to be like, sound like I was playing a fucking harmonica or some shit like that.
Then if you don't blow right, they tell you hum longer, blow longer, all this kind of shit. Man, that shit is the worst, bro.
Well,
the worst.
No
and
more
around here in Texas, you know how it goes. So
yeah, I don't play that shit. Can you do the I'm not taking the breathalyzer shit and just fucking roll the dice?
Hey, I caught the case leaving a company Christmas party. So right around Christmas time, it's automatically no refusal. No really? Refusal.
Damn.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I didn't know. Cause...
Around holidays, no refusal. If you don't want to blow, fine. They'll take your ass to the hospital and draw your blood. Mm. Either way.
I don't even know how that goes, like, depending on when you drank. Because can't you get drunker than you are, like... Is that possible, John?
Yeah, when I was arrested, that's what the cops told me. You know, if you're still going up and you're on your way to the hospital, it's actually going to be worse when they draw your blood. It's like, huh, that's good information.
Yeah,
yeah, because you got to metabolize that shit, soak it up, like, fuck.
Yeah.
What'd you end up blowing?
You sit up and then draw your shit. Mm. I think it was over 0.8, but under 0.15 or some shit.
Oh, that's rough. Yeah, well, and that's after a company Christmas party and shit. Like, come on, man.
Right.
That nigga's so easy to arrest motherfuckers for DUIs. Like anywhere that's not a big city, you're just asked the fuck out.
Hey, that's the fucked up part about it. I work for an all-white company. I'm the only black dude there. I'm the only one went to jail that night.
They pulled over. You're the only one they pulled over? They were like, oh, this motherfucker. Let's get his ass.
Man, I was dropping my manager off at a hotel. Hotel parking lot. Yeah.
Bro, that's so lame. Yeah. The levels of fucking lameness to this shit is just killing me. I'm glad glad that that's behind you. And fucking Uber, I guess. Fucking Uber. Or find a different drug that you can't test with.
Yeah, no shit, man.
Yeah. All right, 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Congrats, you are off of probation. Who else we got?
Lauren, over in Detroit with you.
Hey, Lauren, what's up?
Hey, I'm feeling good because I hit you up on a dating app and you responded, so I'm feeling pretty good today.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Dude, I was like, I'm working right now. I can't talk. And now we get to chat. So there it is. Yes. Yeah. Congratulations for not being... For actually being good looking. Congratulations to you on that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for assuming you can trust my pictures. You can. You actually can. But I appreciate that.
There it is. Yeah. I don't know. She might look like a troll in person, but she you photograph well, Lauren. God damn it.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Well, damn. Thank you. Damn.
Dating
app. Well, I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I couldn't think of something clever to hit you up with, so I figured I'd do this.
There it is. Yeah. That's the thing.
Well,
you heard all my stories. You still want to fuck with me. That's awesome. She doesn't scare easily. All right. Awesome. All right. Yeah. I'll talk to you later. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
Made a love connection.
Yeah, she was on Hinge.
Hmm. Well, we'll see where that goes.
Yeah, we'll see. We will see.
All right, I've got.
I'm kind of afraid to holler at somebody seriously that listens to the show that much, you know.
Oh, I know exactly what you mean.
I need someone that never heard of me. Like, oh, you do what? You do what? Where?
The women I've met through the show and I've had them on the air, that always implodes. I mean, it's just a train wreck. I mean, I've just got wreckage behind me. So, I'd like to avoid that. Seriously.
Same. Even if they do well on the air, it ends up remember when we had the sperm count shit.
Yes.
And me, John, and Chris all had a competition to see who had the best sperm, and we had our sperm tested and the whole fucking nine. And you weren't supposed to fuck for 4 days. You weren't supposed to bust a nut for 4 days. And I end up fucking this young lady I was seeing, and she got on the mic and she was talking shit to you and talking shit because I was like, all right, man, if I'm going to fuck you, you're going to have to fucking say something for the radio. Why I lost. And that one turned bad, dude. She was like, she started going to Al-Anon because of my ass. I'm like, I didn't even know we was that close.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, she's like, I had to go to Al-Anon because of you. I'm like, really? For real?
Trail of tears.
I know, dog. I was like, shit.
Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. If you want shit to go bad, just fucking have them on the radio
come
show.
Come on the air. It'll be fun.
Yeah, come on on.
Not fun.
I can't think of it. Yeah, I can't think of it one time where it turned out good. God damn. Yeah, don't shit where you eat, I guess, is the lesson to be learned. All right, who else we got?
Corey in Maine.
Corey.
Hey, what's up, Jude?
What
I
up?
I hope you don't get catfished with that last lady. I hope she's gorgeous and not some fat bitch.
I do too.
I'm feeling good. I got promoted. got promoted. I'm going to fuck my wife in the ass tonight.
Though, look at you fucking just a... what position do you enter your wife? It sounds like this isn't your first time butt-fucking the old wifey.
Oh, it is.
Oh, it is?
Oh, it is the first time.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
So you got some techniques to get her primed? Or are you just going to jam your dick in there and she's going to be like, yeah. Ah!
No. We're going to even do it. Juice her up and we'll get her into it.
There it is. That's the way to go. That's the way to do it. You take your time. You'll get there. You'll get there. That's not for you. That's for everyone listening. All right. It sounds like you got it under control. 888-742-3345. He feels good about sodomizing his wife.
Jordan, New Mexico.
Jordan in New Mexico. What up?
What's up, Jude? What the fuck is up, man?
Man, we over here fucking doing Feel Good Friday. What are you feeling good for?
Man, I'm feeling good for, you know, being sober for 1 year, 2 months, and 13 days, man.
Hell yeah. Good for you. Good for you.
Sir.
Today was my 1 week.
Yeah, man. Just, do what?
Today was 1 week sober for me, and you got a year.
Hey, man, it's been hard, you know, but it's improving, getting my kids back in my life. And so I'm actually going to be fighting for custody. She don't know it yet, but I'm coming.
Are you gonna try to get joint custody or just full custody?
Nah, man, I'm trying to get full custody. She cheated on me with my little brother after I was with that bitch for 10 years, bro. And, you know, long story short, she fucking took everything I had. She came to kill, steal, and destroy, man. She's a fucking devil. But, you know, the tables have turned now. I'm in position. And,
Is she fucking up?
It's about to go off, man.
Is she fucking up at all?
Yeah,
or you
man.
Just, oh, what's she doing wrong? Because,
well,
you know how the judges are. They're tough. It's tough to get fucking full custody from a chick, bro. Like, what, she smoking crack or some shit?
Well, her and her boyfriend, you know what I mean? That they doing drugs and drinking and heavy and partying and shit, and they don't even know. But they're about to get hit with a hair follicle. You know what I mean?
There it is. Get your kids back and fuck that chick. She's gonna take you. She's gonna fuck your brother and then take your everything.
Man, dog, it's been a hell of a run, man. But hey. Thank you for letting me call in, man. You have a hell of a day, and take care, man. Peace.
Congrats on your sobriety. It sounds like it means a lot to you. So, and there's nothing wrong with that. So, there you go. I say I'm sober, but I really don't give a fuck, just so y'all know. Like,
it's a surprise.
What do you mean it's a surprise?
I know exactly that would be your position on this. Which is not a bad thing.
Yes, it's just
what it is. I mean, okay. Some people come out and say that they've, you know, found the light and all this stuff, and I never expected it to be like that.
You didn't think I was going to last that long in rehab, did you?
No, I did not. When you said you were coming out after a week, I said, yep, this is pretty much how I thought this would play out.
What do I do? Listen to fucking another, like, go to 10 more AA meetings a day? Like, I heard it.
I knew you'd get bored. I knew it. I knew you would.
They make it really hard to stay in there, I'm telling you. Right. You're not going to just get me to stick around because you got Lorna Dunes. But, them fucking shortbread cookies. All right, who else we got?
Tim in Vancouver.
Tim.
What's going on, Jude?
Shit, yeah. What are you feeling good about?
All right, so Feel Good Friday. So I got a never say die attitude because I just had my leg amputated like 5 months ago.
Why'd you have
I'm
to
already
get a-
up and walk and get...
Why'd you have to get amputated?
You know, long story. Doesn't, you know, at this point, let's just say it's a Feel Good Friday. So we'll keep it on the Feel Good.
Are you the one that brought it up, dog? You brought it up. You didn't think
no,
I was going to ask
you?
Come on, man.
Well, you know. Okay, so listen. Bad behavior by Pfizer. Let's just leave it at that. But I feel, listen, it's true, right? But I'm going back to work on Monday, so it's a feel-good Friday, and I got lots to, like I said. But and listen, I'm also feeling good about guys like you on the satellite radio system. So,
thank you. I appreciate
I bought your book, and I bought
thank
your you. And I bought your book too, man. So,
my man.
Anyways,
some light reading.
What?
Yo, yeah, after you're having your leg amputated, do you got the ghost leg shit, or where you can feel it where it's not there, or is it just? What's it feel like?
Well, you know, it feels kind of weird still, but I'm just getting used to the prosthetic, right? I've only had the fake leg now for about 4 weeks, so.
Is it like one of those
process?
What's it look like? Is it like one of those weird like ski legs that you see in like that the action sports people have, or is it like a foot? What is it?
No. Yeah, I got a really good one. It was really expensive. It's got a vacuum system. It almost acts like a normal foot.
You got a girl?
It's serving. Do I? Yeah. Well, oh, for sure, man.
Well, I was gonna say. I'm sure. I was gonna say there's probably some chicks out there that are into fucking that banging dudes with one leg.
You'd be surprised, right?
I wouldn't tell your girl like you got options now. Say right. I might have lost a leg, but I picked up some more options, so you better watch out.
No, it's true. It does gather a lot of attention when you're out in public, but and plus, like I said, I'm already back in the gym, dude. I gotta never say die attitude, man. And I'm still looking for accountability towards the people who cost me my leg. But we'll get through it.
Yeah, look. I hope you do. I hope you do get some resolution, whether it's from the judges or just within yourself. I wish you peace, sir. I wish you peace.
Yeah. You too, man. And like I said, I draw strength from you, man. You're a strong guy, and like I said, I love you.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it. I'm just out here trying like everybody else is. We're all trying the best we can. 888-742-3345.
Stephanie in South Carolina.
Hey, Stephanie.
Hey, I just want to let you know about my Feel Good Friday.
Let's hear it.
I heard you talking about AA.
All right.
I heard you talking about AA. I was in AA for 25 years, but for the last 5 years, I've been drinking my ass off.
Relapse.
And I never felt better.
What's your drink of choice? Do you have one?
Tequila.
There it is. Gold or silver? Añejo or fucking silver? I don't even know. What's Añejo and what's the other?
Yayo, tequila. Yeah, right. We can do it all right now because we have a little bit more understanding with those Lauren Doodle cookies. Yeah, they serve us.
Yeah, they were good in rehab, but tequila's better outside of it. I feel you. 888-742-3345. Have a drink on me. Have a drink on the show. Here's to you. Bottoms up. Whatever you do, just enjoy doing it. See how she relapsed? Don't beat yourself up for the relapse. When she's ready to quit, she'll quit again.
Tequila, though.
Oof. Yeah.
That's a rough night.
It's kind of
an
upper.
Rough
it's an upper. All right. Well, John, you drink a lot.
That's the problem.
You're
be
a heavy drinker. You are a heavy drinker. John's got that wandering eye. He looks like Mad-Eye Moody after a few. That's when you can tell John's on a good one. His shit goes full pug.
And the bartender says, hey, you want a shot, John?
I guess. Yeah. You know me, I'll turn down a shot.
Cut.
What is it, battery acid? Sure.
Line it up. Brian,
come on.
Hermosa Beach.
Brian, what up, though?
Well, what up, Judy? Hey, man, I'm feeling good today. I'm about to jump on a private jet out to Vegas.
Damn. Why are you going on a private jet?
Man.
Are you a big-time gambler, or you just got rich friends?
Nah, man, my buddy just got engaged to his chick. She's smoking hot, and she's got a bunch of hot like friends, like some OnlyFans models. So we're all jumping on the jet together, going out there and just, you know, getting nasty.
You know you are going to end up fucking one of those girls. You have fun with that shit.
I fucking hope so. Otherwise, why am I doing it?
Just don't try. Just let it fall in your lap. You know what I'm saying? You do.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
If you try, they're going to smell that shit on you. If you don't, they'll be like, how come he's not paying attention to me? He reminds me of my dad. Then I have issues with him.
No one likes to smell of desperation.
No, it's so true. That's one thing I can always say. People, like, if you're on a cold streak, just go get an ugly chick and bang it out, because your dick doesn't know the difference.
It sure doesn't. Yeah. My dick's blind and dumb. hey, one more thing. I sent you I DM'd you a link to how to self-publish on Audible.
Oh, for real? Can you re-DM me that shit? Like, because I really need to get. Huh? I didn't even know that was an option.
I sent it to All Out Show.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I'll look into that. Now it's just about getting the studio time and fucking recording the shit. Yeah, because that I was waiting on that agent, and it was not helping. I appreciate that. Look at you, fucking go-getter.
Hey, man, you know, I just trying to do it for the All Out family.
I appreciate you. Like, I'm real good at, like, the front end of business, not the back end. Like, I'm good at making shit as far as, like, how to self-publish. I'm like, ah, shit, I don't know. I'm fucking dumb. I'm not a triple threat. We'll just put it that. Who we got?
Got Joe in Richmond, Virginia.
Joe.
Hey, how's it going, Jude? How you doing?
Fucking awesome. Sitting here with a hookah talking to y'all cats.
Hey, not bad, not bad. Hey, Jude, I'm feeling good. I'm in the military. Did 12 years. And this is my final contract, so I'm switching over to the civilian life.
Nice. Are you gonna go like private sector, or are you just gonna get away from military altogether?
I'm going GS civilian, so I'm gonna still stay with soldiers and I still teach them on the civilian side, but get a little freedom back.
Yeah, fuck yeah. I'm sure that's you got like good benefits and shit. 12 years is a long time.
Yeah, it's not bad. Housing, food, it's steady. Every 1st and 15th, got what I needed, and now time to transition and do great things on the other side.
Well, thanks for your service. I don't always agree with our foreign policy, but I always agree with y'all cats. I'll tell you that much.
I listen to you every day on the way home. So thank you, man. Love you.
Yeah, fuck with y'all too, the long way, for real. Shout out to everybody in the military, overseas and at home. Appreciate y'all. Really though. 888-742-3345. All right, I got time for two, John, so fucking make them count.
All right. Don't let me down, Caleb.
Don't let me down. Go ahead.
Caleb in Greenville, North Carolina.
Caleb.
Yo, man, what's good, dude?
Chilling, man. What are you feeling good for?
Man, it's Friday, and man, you always got to feel good on a Friday. Not just that, here come the 12th. I'm going to Jamaica. My job paying for everything. Hey. Rooms there, all inconclusive.
Hey,
drinks,
hey.
Everything, man. Transportation, flights, everything, man.
That's fucking awesome. Have fun down there, bro. Are you going to stay? You're staying at a resort?
Man, I am, bro.
What do you do?
I'm staying at a whole resort, man. Mm.
What do you do to send you down there? Like, what kind of job do you have?
Man, I just got this job like a year ago. I just rode over a year at this job at Verizon. I sell phones.
Damn.
And, like,
that's
I was a
awesome.
Top seller for the whole year out of like a couple hundred people.
Hustle up.
Like,
what's the key?
It's a blessing.
What's the key to be a top seller?
You said what?
What's the key? What's your, like?
You said a top seller.
No, a top seller. What's the key to being a top seller?
Oh, top seller. Man, you just got to tell the people what they want to hear. Everybody loves promotions. When you tell somebody you about to be getting this money off, may have, a couple back doors, so you got to read the fine print. But all my job is to get the people in the door, man. It's just about finessing. That's all they got to do. I don't even have to sell the phone personally.
tell them what they want to hear. That's you heard it here first.
How do you sell what they want to hear, man.
Yep. That's how you get
pussy,
too.
Tell them what they want to hear.
Yes. Indeed. And have fun down in Jamaica.
Man, I will, bro. I appreciate you having me on the show, man. I appreciate it. Happy Friday to everybody out there listening, man. Just keep your head up. I don't care if you're sad now. Just be happy later.
All right, there it is. It is All Out Show. That's last one, Feel Good Friday. Who is it?
John in Texas.
John in Texas.
Yo, Jude, what up?
Fucking chilling, man. What are you feeling good about?
Yo, man. Got two jobs, hustling, just bought a $100,000 truck.
Damn.
I'm killing it, man. But
what do you
real
do?
We'll talk the whole reason I'm calling.
Yeah.
John's a bitch.
Damn,
John's a
dog.
Bitch.
Fucking dick.
Damn,
fuck
son.
You, John.
Suck a dick.
No, John, you're a bitch.
Why am I a bitch?
You know
in the back of your head I could beat your fucking ass these days. I will lift you up, motherfucker.
I'm going to whoop your ass, John.
Oh, get the fuck out of here. I'll be back in Texas.
No, fuck you, John. Come to Texas. I'm going to whoop your ass.
Oh, God. You know that's not true. You can feel it in your heart that I would beat the fuck out of you.
John, come to Texas. I'm going to whoop your ass.
Uh-huh. Okay. Hey.
How big? What do you weigh?
I'm like 190.
Okay. So he's got you. He's got you by about 50 pounds, John. Jesus Christ. Let him bring him back.
John?
Let him bring him back.
All right, listen. All right, hey, come on, John, I can still drop you. That's fine. Hey, really, I would get in close, and I would take care of you, get you down on the ground, go to work on your eyeballs, maybe some groin work. I would fuck you up.
Eyeballs and nutsack. He's coming for you. He's coming for you, bro. Watch out.
I've got a vasectomy, but I'm still going to kill you.
Uh-huh.
He said he's going to work your groin. I don't know what that means. You're either going to come or be really hurt, one of the two. Either way, you're going to be folded up when John gets done with you. I'm going to go inside. I'm going to work the inside. I'm going to work your groin. Maybe your eyeballs. The fuck, John?
Secret weapons.
Got to run around the room, get them gassed, and then fucking
190, though.
Yeah.
Those big guys, they're trouble.
Yeah, but that's why they get them gassed out. And fucking get them. Oh. I wouldn't go inside. I'd stay away.
Yeah, it's true.
Get them swinging. Punch yourself out, and then that's when you get them.
Bang, bang.
All right, so we got another. It looks like there's another fight lined up for Ellis Mania. John versus random dude in Texas that has a $100,000 truck.
Wow.
Tell him to put up his pink slip.
Man.
His pink slip against your fucking everything you own. And you'll still be short, but still. Still. All right, that was Feel Good Friday. We got, what is it? The news coming up next?
The news is coming up next. The
news is coming up next. Don't go anywhere. And thanks to everybody that grabbed the book. You can go on Amazon. You can get it only there. Amazon Finn, the book is out right now. It's the third book. You can read it in any order. Hyena, Hummingbird, Finn. Boom. I'm only telling you that about that because it's good for you. You need this book. I'm telling you. You need this motherfucker. Let's go.
I don't think these peeps know. Yo, it's finally on for real, dude. Brothers better recognize. Smith and Wesson up in the chain. Fuck down, boot camp. Bring it some. Freeze like a rock on the block with the cops carry.
And the hard rocks carry. You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
I have someone writing in to Insider asking advice from their resident sex and relationships expert.
Okay.
And she's saying here, so she's a lesbian. She is hanging out with some lady. And I only orgasm during sex if my partner demeans me and makes me cry. Oh
my God. Somebody got abused as a child. She went full-blown, like, lesbian fucking... Cry nut. She bust tearful nuts as a lesbian.
I honestly don't get that. And I understand a lot of kinks, sort of, but this one I just don't. So why would you want to relive that trauma and then get off?
I don't know, man.
I
don't know. Somewhere deep down inside, like maybe they felt fucked up and paid attention to it at the same time.
Wow.
Molestation is a weird thing. It's coupled with guilt and pleasure and being scared, like a bunch of different emotions.
It gets her off. Now, she does say that she, again, can't orgasm whatsoever, but except for this crygasm, if I don't cry,
crygasm.
I don't feel pleasured. Sometimes Teargasm. I ask her to make me cry to the point of sobbing, whether from words or hard face slaps.
Damn. She sounds like fun, bro.
I don't know. Could you deliver on this front? If some lady said, this is what I need, Jude. This is what's going on.
Yeah, bro.
I don't think I could.
Check out the book Hyena.
Okay, man, that's right.
Proving that, yes, I can do that
yes,
for you.
You can.
Yes, I can. I only can do it if you like it, though.
Right.
Like, I'm not into fucking making you feel bad for no reason. You gotta like feeling all fucked up.
Oof.
And then I can deliver.
Take that.
Take that. Never thought that you needed that, did you? You little fucking whore.
Now,
that's why your dad left.
Now, this sex expert here says, first of all, she should probably go and get some counseling, figure this shit out. But as for the crygasms, you know, it's no big deal. It's possible that these intimate moments with your girlfriend are providing much-needed stress relief. That's normal.
Mm-hmm.
Both crying and sex with partners can be a vulnerable and cathartic process.
Get some release. I did find that, like, sometimes with some of these ladies... Like, you keep going back to the well with that one. You got to, like, chill out because it gets pretty dark after a while. You're like, damn, dog. Can we just have... Can
we just...
So like, can I just bust a normal nut, you know? Like, out fucking dogging him. Like, yeah, you fucking hole. Give me that fucking pussy. That's all you're good for.
You're my cum sock. Very nice.
You're my little cum sock. So I thought, shut the fuck up. There's been times I just put my hand on, shut up. Shut up and take this dick.
Have you ever been in a position where the lady says, hey, ho, ho, too much. Here's my safe word.
The funny thing was, is like, we were doing some shit like that, and OG was getting, like, just fucking, she went from, like, regular to pouring. My dick was, like, in a rainforest, you know what I mean? Like, it was fucking wet than a motherfucker. And finally, like, she shook off, and she's like, what's wrong with you? I was like, I thought you liked that shit. And I hated it. I was like, tell that shit to your pussy. She was like, you're fucked up. I had to go sit on the porch on mushrooms. We were both on mushrooms. I had to sit on there on mushrooms thinking about my life and decisions that I made and shit. So it's just,
how did I get here?
Yeah. Like, your mind's telling me no, but your body is telling me yeah.
All right. So, of course, Kanye, or Ye, I guess. I don't know, man. I'll call you whatever you want.
Ye? Is that what he is called now?
That's what he wants to be called.
Jesus Christ, dude. Yeah. Yay! Yay! Laughing yoga, yay!
But so these TMZ reporters, they are pretty shameless in terms of just stopping people and asking just crazy questions. And so someone found Gene Simmons outside of a restaurant and just started to just pepper him with questions about Kanye.
What the fuck does Gene... I had picked that shit because I thought Gene Simmons got his big fucking rocker nose involved in this shit. Like, shut the fuck up, Gene Simmons. Nobody asked you about Kanye West, but apparently TMZ asked you repeatedly about Kanye West.
I'm not going to play the whole thing. It's 2 minutes. And, I mean, it looks cut, so she just drilled down. I mean, who...
And that guy's like, he's got a way with... Like, he's a talker, too. Like, so Gene Simmons is probably just going in, like...
He's got some things to say here. But.
Gene's got some shit on his mind.
Here we go.
It was a psychological problem.
Do you think him and Pete need to file a restraining order against Kanye?
I don't need to do that.
Yeah.
Pete's a cool guy. Takes the high road and just ignore it.
Ignore it?
Yeah. No, at a certain point, if everybody misbehaves, a good bitch slap. Oh, sorry, I didn't realize I was such an asshole.
Is that what Kanye needs?
Are you going to do it?
No.
Yeah. That's
all right, it goes on. And he's.
Are you going to do it? Fucking you vampire?
Oh, can you imagine being that person who has to go out there and ask these questions?
I would never do that shit.
By the way, I actually applied for that job before.
Those people are like, they're just bad for the world.
Before I got hooked up with you, I applied for that job, and I didn't get it, obviously, but you know, they started asking me questions. What would you ask this person? I'm like, fuck if I know. Maybe who are you?
And Pete Davidson's like, what I say yesterday from the show, when Kanye like had the video of him doing all that weird shit, I was like, watch, it's just gonna make Pete Davidson more popular. That's exactly what he did. Pete Davidson's more popular than ever.
All right, here's a question for you. So if you were Pete Davidson, how would you respond to this? I mean, obviously, he seems to be taking the high road.
I'll do exactly what he's doing.
Just ignore it. Just take the high road.
Who cares? Like, I'm getting shouted out by Kanye, and I'm fucking his ex. I'm fucking Kim K and getting shouted out by Kanye. And he doesn't have to do shit but sling dick and listen to her at dinner and shit, which is probably a lot. She probably doesn't have much to say that's interesting, but, you know, whatever.
What about from a security point of view? Should he be worried? Or
no, Kanye's fucking like, he's not affiliated or no shit like that. He's straight.
Okay.
Dude went to college.
That's right.
Not saying that, like, going to college equals a certain thing. I'm just saying, you know, like, come on.
All right, so looks like men struggle to say, I love you.
Yeah, because that's like opening a can of worms.
Apparently. And also women are a little hesitant because they're afraid of scaring the guys off. is it implies a level of commitment that the other person may not be ready for. What's wrong with saying I love you? What's wrong with that?
You fucking simp.
All right, fine.
How long do you wait to say I love you anyway? Just whenever it hits you?
Pretty much, and it's always too soon.
I fucking love you, babe.
I love you, man.
What?
Excuse me?
They pat you on the head and shit? Oh.
Isn't that cute?
The silence.
I've had that.
Oh, buddy.
I know, it's terrible.
That's painful. I love you. I said I love you.
I know.
I'm gonna big old lub. I don't know what that means, but yeah, I love you a lot.
How long do you wait?
I think I'm told someone I loved them in fucking forever. I usually be like, I love you too. I just wait for them to say it. And if I feel that way, I'll be like, I love you too. But it's got to be quick. Or I mean, it's got to be, it takes a while.
Right.
And the other thing too is like, you know, let the chick say that shit. I'm not going to put myself out there.
Why not? I mean,
because I don't feel it half the fucking time, to be all the way real with you.
Okay. Well, that's real. That's authentic. All right.
But, like, I can tell friendly people, like, on some friendship, yeah, I love you. Like, because I know it's not going to amount to, it doesn't matter.
I love you, bro.
Yeah, it's like chicks. Oh, I love you, dude. Yeah, I love you, too. You be well. Like, I'm lying. Like, you could disappear right now. You're just over here to do my coke. Whatever, dude. Like, I love you. All right, sure.
Cold.
Who's cold? The person coming over to my house thinking they're finessing me for coke or me to not buying the I love you shit? Which one of us is the asshole here?
The coke stealer.
Yeah. I mean, they're not stealing. I'm giving to them. But I know that they're not. Oh, bitch, you are not slick. I just felt like having some female energy around me.
All right. Well, then I've got to ask you a question. And not to get too deep into this, but I mean, how do you know when you're in love? I mean, is there like a line? Like, okay, I now love this person.
Man, like you just have you just it's just a feeling. Probably the feeling that you get. You know what I mean? It's just that feeling that you get. You're happy to see them. You're excited. You're fucking. You have genuine. Your heart opens up for them and shit. And it could take. Who knows? You might fall in love overnight, and it might take months. So
maybe even after one blowjob. Who knows?
Is that how it went down, John?
I can't remember. I don't know.
I fucking love you, babe.
I love you.
Let's snowball. What's snowballing? Don't worry about it. Just spit it back in my mouth. It's cool.
Yeah, that's love.
I said no homo earlier. It's okay. I love you. I just want to show you how much.
Women do not find that attractive, let me tell you.
What, telling them that you love them too early?
Yes.
Yeah. How early is too early? You weren't really specific.
Oh. I mean, I would have to say, you know, like a month, maybe. I think I kind of just got caught up in my stupidity at some point.
Yeah, pumped the brakes on that shit.
Yeah, dumb.
I've done that. I've spilled my guts to, like, strippers before. You know, like, everybody, like, coming up, you just do that shit. No, nobody's, like, hats off to you if you've just been the coolest guy ever. And just been able to be cool forever and never made a mistake in the cool zone. Hats off to you, man. You're the coolest guy ever. I was not the coolest guy ever. And I've backfired. I've fucked up a couple of times like that. Like, oh man, dog, like that stripper guy had your nose open like that. Like, she's just, ugh, what's wrong with you? Never again. Never again.
I have some tips here. When you have a car crash, what should one do?
Never say, I'm sorry. Because isn't that like admission of guilt or some shit?
I mean, I think that falls under one of these suggestions here. Being too chatty. Shut the fuck up. Just don't.
Don't say shit.
Yeah, I mean, that's not going to help you. I mean, when I see these people on the side of the road chatting, like, what are they talking about? Just take a photo and wait for the cops or something. I mean...
Yeah,
apologizing. But so again, call the police. I don't know. Have you ever been in a wreck where you didn't call the cops?
Tons of times.
Yeah, me too.
I'm just like,
yeah, whatever.
Last time I got rear-handed, I didn't call the cops. I was just like, I just got his number, and I was like, if it's fucked up, I'll hit you. And if it costs more than my fucking thing, like, we can figure it out.
But I guess the problem there is you're trusting this person to set you up. And
I took a picture of his ID.
Okay.
Like I got a picture of his license. Now, if he went as far as having a fake license to show me, there's what am I going to do? You know, whatever. He rear-ended me. Like, I don't take that shit personal either.
No, it's just
some of those people, like, they get hit in the car and they act like the dude that hit him, like, got woke up that day and was like, I'm gonna hit Bart Simpson, and I'm gonna rear end that motherfucker mad hard and fucking ruin his day. That's what I'm out to do, because fuck Bart Simpson, because it sounds like a fucking cartoon.
Here comes the pain.
And they'll be all mad and shit, ready to fight you. Like, yo, dog, like, calm down. It was an accident.
Now, also, clearly, even in your case, you don't want to underestimate your injuries. You could have a concussion. You might have that whiplash thing happening. So, you know, you've got the adrenaline thing going, so you're a little distracted with these chemicals in your body. You may be kind of fucked up.
That could be true. Yeah. That's what I said that, too. I was like, man, I don't know, if, like, how my neck's going to be or what, but I'll scream at you when I figure it out. And he's like, okay. Okay, buddy. Like, you got it, pal.
And this is very important. After an accident, there will be a lot of questions from onlookers, the other driver, the police. Under such circumstances, chances of admitting or implying fault are very high. Again, shut up. Just talk to your attorney. Get an attorney. If it's like a serious wreck, there's no real benefit in you chatting these people up at the scene of the accident.
No. You're adamant about this one, John.
I am.
Does this hit close to home? Does something happen?
No, but
I need to know about.
No, but there's just I see this all the time. I don't understand why people talk to cops. By the way, I love the police, sort of, but just talking to them, there's no upside in my mind. You're just kind of fucking yourself. Like, oh
yeah, dog. You're just yeah. Hey, I'm gonna go talk to that cop over there. Like, shout out to the cops that listen to
this.
Yes, shit,
love
like,
him. But
we got a bunch of them. But like, he's got a point, dog. Like, it's like. Nothing's good is gonna come from that shit, especially like L.A.
They're not your friend.
You don't even know the cop. They're always swapping cops operating in your neighborhood, so you don't even know who the cool cop is and who the fucking asshole cop is. Cause there can be cool cops, dog. Like, they don't feel like busting you for fucking dumb shit.
Yeah, I think there was somebody up north, some sort of marijuana thing, and some like serious feds were involved. And I was just dumbfounded. I was like, why are you talking to them?
It's the feds
why,
are there.
Why are you talking to these people? All right, sorry.
That don't make no sense.
All right, somewhat strangely enough here, I have some interesting facts about water.
Water.
According to Discover Magazine.
Agua.
So how much is there on the planet? Can you come up with
a billion? A billion water.
According to this, estimated 326 million trillion gallons.
326 million trillion?
I don't even know what that means. Do you even know what that means? That's a big number.
That's a million trillions.
I know.
1 million trillions is a lot. That's a lot. Somebody was like, the Earth is 75% water. Just like us. But I don't know if they're saying that to be cute or what. I was like, oh, that's interesting. And I never looked it up. Now I'm over here spreading false information. That's how false information gets spread, just like that.
People remember it. Jude said. Well,
Jude said, blah, 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 blah.
He's on the radio.
Jude also doesn't know. Jude's a fucking moron. Jude knows he's a moron. All right.
And
what else?
Our bodies are more than half water. Water is involved in many functions needed for bodily systems, including removing waste, regulating body temperature, lubricating, cushioning joints, things like that.
All right.
Now, this one seems a little fishy, but the water cycle is 3.8 billion years old. And I guess the idea is that there's a set amount of water, and then it just, of course, evaporation, raining.
Where does the new water come from then?
I don't think there is. Is there new water? See, that's the problem.
So are we slowly becoming a desert planet? Is that what they're trying to tell me?
Well, no, they're saying it's an endless process that connects water in all its different forms. So it's just in this constant cycle.
You know, real cold hard water is called?
I do not.
Ice.
Ah, thank you. That's an interesting fact. Let me make a note of that.
Fucking ice.
See? You're a scientist.
I'm fucking scientific. Terrific.
All right. And finally, water is a compound. There you go. Made up of two hydrogen
H2O.
Atoms. That is correct, sir.
H. And then what is it? Two hydrogens and one oxygen? Is that it? H2O?
Two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom.
Bam. Look at me. And I wasn't fucking dumb people science. I wasn't dumb people everything.
It's considered a compound and a molecule. Back when people were kind of stupid, it was considered an element. But thankfully, we outgrew that.
Then they figured that shit out. They got the, what is it, the periodic chart or some shit? What was it called?
Right, the periodic table, I think. Boy, that was so confusing to me. I looked at that and I said, boy, I'm not a chemist. I don't know what the fuck's going on there.
I don't know, Doug.
I was like, this is not for me.
That's just, yeah. I still, like, some people know that shit by heart. I'm like, how the fuck do you know that shit? I think I looked at, like, the letters. I was like, cool font. That's all I remember. Like, oh, nice font. Looks stylish. I'm out.
Glad somebody,
ego.
Glad somebody understands it. I hear some good news.
Let's hear it.
And now, time for good news.
So this is cute. There was a boy, you may have come across this on Twitter.
I'll be the judge of that. Okay.
All right, there was a boy who lost his teddy bear in an airport. And
how old is he? 27?
Yeah, he was a little old. No, he's 5.
Ah.
Little Ezekiel. So he was tossing his bear high above his head.
Was he tossing his bear salad?
He's okay. Oh, that's off. All right, but so the kid, he's just playing catch with the bear, and the parents say, hey, Ezekiel, cool it.
It's cool
little,
it down.
A little too high. And then it eventually got caught in the rafters. And they had to catch the flight, so they had to leave. They had to abandon the little teddy bear. But it eventually fell down. The airport found it. And somebody, you know, they put it online on Facebook. Hey, is this your bear? And amazingly, Facebook being what it is, the mom saw it and proved that this
Jesus Christ, dude.
Teddy was reunited with little Ezekiel.
There it is. That story was, man, that so many ups and downs in that story.
Do you have any stuffed animals from your youth? Probably not. You got a little teddy bear?
No. No, but I used to have like a little teddy bear I slept with all the time. I don't know what happened to that fucking thing. I think I threw it out or some shit.
Cold.
Be
man.
A man. Be a fucking man.
Do you remember its name?
I think it was like Teddy or some shit like that. Or
Teddy.
I don't. What was your bear's name? What'd you have?
Corduroy.
His name was Corduroy?
Yeah. Little bear Corduroy. A little sweater
Corduroy?
On him. Yeah.
Sounds like a real faggot.
Hey. He was hard.
He was hard as nails. Corduroy. Was he made out of corduroy or you just called him corduroy?
No, I just called him corduroy.
Hey, that's even better. All right, corduroy. This one's for you, corduroy. That's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, that was the show. Thanks to Xzibit for stopping in. X to the Z-I-B-I-T. Is that it? Xzibit?
Xzibit.
Yeah, E-X-Z-I-B-I-T,
right?
Xzibit. I think that's it. Xzibit on everything. He came in first hour. John Z. Matthews, Kylo Keen, follow at All Out Show. My shit got taken down. You can follow me on Instagram at J. Anthony Angelini. And grab the book, Hummingbird, Hyena, or Finn, all available on Amazon. Boom. We out this boot. Have a good weekend.